So next I'm going to put the chocks into the grills here. And I'm going to only be doing the large grill to demonstrate. I've already done the others, but this is a good example of this. And I know I've shown this before, so I'm not going to try to go into too much detail with this. Just to give you guys a basic idea, I just kind of scrub the powder into the grill itself. And I just kind of keep it random. Because if you look at how grime builds up in these things, I mean, it's not all one solid perfect color. So I try to keep it kind of with a random look, something like that, where you can kind of see it's very blotchy and patched up. But once I go over this, I just go back again and keep streak it down. There we go. So again, this is another one of those things you can kind of go in detail with. I've seen some of these grills where they're very powdery black colored. Some of them might have a little white dust in them. Just depends. Again, with the prototype photos on this engine, they're just kind of a grimy color. So I'm just going to stick with the straight earth brown chalk colors. Now, looking at another part of the engine here, I'll work on the top in a second, but we'll go ahead and start layering some grime on the walkway here. You can see I've already done the washes on each individual panel. And I love the Athern units with this, the etched walkway material, because it really stands out and it's really fun to weather this stuff. You can really have a lot of fun with it. But again, since it's somewhat of a fresh repaint, most of this is in pretty good shape. It's just a layer of grime over it. But I've done chipping effects on the sills, all kinds of cool effects. It just depends on the prototype. Anyway, I'm going to switch now again to my grime brush here, my smaller grime brush. Pick up a decent layer of chalk, and I'll just start layering it carefully on these steps. Again, higher traffic areas like this are going to be where most of the grime is going to accumulate. So I try to have a heavier concentration around the doors of the cab and stuff like that. But again, this is another one of those things you can kind of keep random, just in random little areas. Going to kind of have this so that it's brushed up against the sill of the engine here, right up against the edge where the walkway meets the car body. That's where I'm kind of working this in right now. And then I'm just kind of streaking it out a little bit, like this. But a little of this chalk goes a long way, excuse me, so you don't need so much of it. But I'm just trying to kind of create that wash effect of some of that grime streaking down the walkway, and it starts to bleed down over and then onto the fuel tank a little bit. That's kind of what I'm going with for look-wise here. Do one more little section here real quick, and I'll come back and finish this later, but for the sake of time, I'll just do this one little area again. And then I'll move on to the front of the nose here to, again, give you a good idea of what I'm talking about with that high traffic area. These areas get especially dirty, and this is where I really concentrate a lot of that powder and such. So again, I'll take a little bit more of the chalk, a little bit heavier build up here. I'm going to really kind of just build it up here, clump it on. I already put some chalk in the walkways, the steps, earlier when I was doing the sills, so those are taken care of. It's just putting the grime in the actual walkway. See if I can move this and get a little bit better lighting here for you guys too. Here we go. Let's see. But like this anti-climber especially, this is where a lot of this grime is going to be built up. So really concentrate your heaviest buildup on this area. High traffic area, there's a lot of crap coming up off the plow, kick up spray and stuff like that. Put a little bit on the nose while I'm at it here too. Not too much, just a little bit of grime around the toilet hatch here. I'm not building it up on the top, only around where the rust is going to be concentrated. Just a little bit here and there. And I just kind of blotch it on. But you can see it gives this slight, subtle halo effect. It's not going to focus, but you can kind of see that rust halo around that hatch. That's what we're going for. Alright. So, switch angles here a little bit. Now we'll work on these top of the engine. Not too much need for grime up here unless the prototype demands it, but again, I'm just going to put a little bit here in certain areas. You can see I did some detail work on the fans, put the grime and everything on them. So I'm going to put just a little bit on the tops of these, but again, only a little. Just a slight little bit here and there in the raised areas, because this is where you see a lot of that dusty grime kind of build up from the circulation of the fans. So just a little bit. Again, it's really simple on this particular engine. I'll put a little bit on this section here in the sill. And build it up in these raised areas. Just kind of keeping it sort of random right now. I don't have prototype photos of the top of the engine, so I'm kind of just guesstimating this. And this is where you got to kind of use a little bit of an artistic license to kind of model what you want here, but just keeping it simple. Looking at this little hatch here, I put a little grime around this little outlet, or this little vent here. And I always put a little bit of a grime buildup around this. Just a little bit. Put it right in the grill, and then I like to have it where it's just bleeding down like that, just a little bit. Now this hatch where the dynamic fan is, this usually gets pretty dirty too, so I'm gonna really layer the chalk in this. So I'm gonna get a bit of a heavier layer, and I'm gonna do some of the heat damage just a little bit and just kind of roughly scrub it in. I'm gonna put some of that heavier chalk or the powder in this in a second, but on the cab roof you can see I've done a little bit of a dusting, but not too much, just on the top of the AC unit and some other little random areas where the rust might build up real quick. But I'll do a little bit of a streak down the cab, just a little bit, very light though. Now as we look at this, we've pretty much done the rust effects on the roof. That's pretty much covered. What we're going to do now is put the actual exhaust strut sit on the top here. So again, I'll switch my brushes, and I have my dark grime color now. Dark grime colored brush, I mean. So when I do this, black is a very concentrated color. This will build up very fast, so you want to go light on this. Take a little bit, load it up in your bristles, tap some of it out. You can see how much powder that actually picked up right there, just in that one little bit. Okay. And you can kind of test this sometimes. You can take it on a piece of paper and just kind of see the concentration. But I'd imagine this is pretty big, so that is pretty decent concentration. But I'll go ahead and just pick up a little bit more since I'm going to be working at the hatch here to start. So remember how when this stuff is going to be coming out of this hatch, it's going to be streaking down towards the end of the hood unit, the hood of the unit here. And the heaviest concentration is going to be right in that hatch. I'm not going to make this too grimy though, just a little bit. So right around the hatch it's going to be the heaviest. Streak it out here a little bit. I like to put it up on the clean air duct here, just a little bit. I'm just going to kind of streak it out like that, right across, like that. You can see those streaks right there. But you can see I'm going pretty heavy with this at the moment. Sometimes it's pretty light, sometimes it's sort of minimal. Again, just compare prototype photos. You can see sometimes it can be pretty extreme. For example, I'll bring in an engine here. This is an ECE I'm working on, if I can get it in the shot. This is an MTH unit I did, but you can see that heavy exhaust that I did on the top of this engine, it just is a good example of how heavy it can get. But some of these can be pretty bad like this, others can be pretty minimal. This engine's not too bad, so I'm not going to go too insanely crazy with this. Just a little bit. Now, as we work down the hood, I'm going to start kind of fanning this out a little bit, like this. I'm going to kind of streak it out and start spreading it down the top of the engine, and then I'll continue to kind of build it up and fan it out very slowly. Again, not trying to build this up too much. Going to kind of put a little bit of this powder here in these joints as well. That's going to be areas where soot will build up like this. That was a little too much. Let me grab a Q-tip and wipe that off a little bit. These powders are pretty forgiving before you seal them in, so you don't need to go be too careful with them, but that little area there I can correct kind of quick. The horn is going to be another area, since it's raised off the roof a little bit, where you want to put a lot of that grime. So I put quite a bit of powder on that. Looking into the bells of the horn, I always take my micro brush like this. I'll pick up the straight powder and I'll put it in the bells of the horn. Like that. So that I can darken that down a little bit. There we go. Now again, this fan's going to be really dirty here, so we'll go ahead and put some of that on this. Sorry, I keep bumping the camera here, guys. It's hard doing this when it's in my way, but I'm going pretty heavy on the buildup on this. I'll do something similar like this to the radiator fans in a second, too. I'll show that before we wrap this clip up, but I'm just going to really build this up. And then I'll fan it out a little bit. Just a little. There we go. You guys can see that nice enhanced detail there with that. And the soot. And again, once I'm done with this, I'll take my fanning brush and fan it off all the extra powder. Just very gently. And then the last little thing I'll do is put a little bit on these fans. And we'll wrap up this clip. These don't get as dirty, but I still like to have the darkening on the top of the grill to make them look a little dusty. Put the soot right on there. And then streak it. Okay, put a little grime on the raised details here, like these bolt details, just a little bit.